Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin wassalatu wassalamu ala syarafil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi washabbi ajmain. Alhamdulillah, we are still discussing on chapter 7 of our book Post-Islamic Psychology: A Transcendent Model to Achieve Peace, Happiness and Success in the 21st Century. So, we are continuing with our example of using CBT and Pi CBT as an example for our approach towards overcoming the problem of depression. There's another example later on the problem of anxiety and anxiety-related disorders. So if we go into the chapter 7, you can go on to the chapter 7. You can see that basically we have this cognitive CBT, and how are we going to approach CBT? Exactly as we want to approach Pi CBT also, but I have developed a framework which is specific to Pi CBT. That is, we have the 5 R. Remember the 5 R. The first R is for us to realize, the realization on both the person who is being given, the client who's been given therapy, as well as the therapist or the life coach or the counselor. So realize, that's the first R. I have explained quite detailed. Then record, all right, and certain aspect we will have to record, whether it's in the form of a diary and various other forms in which we will then show you as toolkit. And then once you have done that, you have done some analysis, then will be reframe. How to reframe the whole cognitive thought processes as well as the inner speech, which comprehends both the inner speech from the perspective of our kalb, our heart. After we have done the understanding of reframing, then when the next step is, we would then use this as a review. We review the process so that the whole cycle of the 4 R is already now taking shape, and inshallah the person who is being given the counseling or the therapy would then be able to have improved. And finally, at the highest level, the person will exit from the need of any more therapy, and they will be able to lead a good life and become self-actualized. As the last R is relive. Relive your life from the negative life to the positive life. So from our book, I'm going to give you some ideas. All right, what makes CBT, Pi CBT different from other therapies? There are many other therapies, but at least we know that CBT is always evidence-based. So it is very important that we start, even for Islamic psychology, we must use what is the most relevant evidence-based therapy or protocol. So we know that CBT has thousands of papers published on the efficacy in terms of many psychological spectrum that we see today. So basically, Pi CBT rely on the patient's active role. They must be active, developing a collaborative relationship with the therapist to identify and resolve the problem. That means it must be a two-way process. It's not just like you sit down, like psychoanalysts, and then you just blubber out whatever that you have to say, and then the person just guide you, or even they go to session of hypnosis, whatever it is. They could use one of those methods, but we are not moving into that direction. Ours is a very focused, collaborative relationship. Number two, it's just like a scientific study. The patient negative thoughts or inner speech become a scientific study over the years. So over the years, they have developed many toolkits, protocol, techniques, and so on, which if we're going to study, there will be so many of them relating to, for example, depression, even depression, relating to anxiety. Even anxiety, they have broken down to many, even, for example, childhood anxiety. Especially in relation to studies, exams, parental love, and so on. So there are many things that we can work on, but at least the framework is to understand what is CBT and Pi CBT. They are just like brothers. Only thing that Pi CBT, we go to at a higher level of our kalb, our heart, and how we are going to relate our FET, feelings, emotion, and thoughts, beyond just the cognitive framework. Okay, duration, if we're going to put this into practice, that means a typical CBT, Pi CBT program consists of 15 to 20 weekly sessions, perhaps twice weekly initially in the case of severe depression. All right, a typical session lasts about 45 minutes to 1 hour, not more than that. You need not be dragging and making yourself tired, and the your client tired. So this is the duration. Agenda, work out at the beginning of every session. So you set agenda. What are you going to tackle based on your record, all right, that you have of your client? What are you are going to tackle? The severity of the problems that you are facing, and based on the previous intervention, how you are going to set the agenda for the session. The therapist will ask what you want to discuss and set targets for the session. So every time you have an agenda, we have a target. Structure, time will be allocated for specific issues. CBT, by CBT, tends to be highly structured. That's why it is very structured protocol, technique, a business-like agenda, problem-solving approach. So we use all the tools of problem-solving. The patient may do increasingly more of the agenda setting and structuring session as they get to know the routine. So as the client know more and more of the routine, then inshallah they'll be able to then take control of their own journey. Because finally at our last R is to relieve. We want them finally to become self-actualized in their own way, so that they do not have to rely on a life coach or a therapist or a counselor to constantly monitor their progress. Because if they once they become self-actualized, they themselves can be mentoring other people. Okay, so what is the issue that we're going to put? We have the session target. Each target we put, we give them, and then they would then be able to access, and then based on that discussion, we may break down the particular problem into different components, because sometimes you cannot chew the whole problem in one go. So you have to have a new perspective, give them a new tool set, give them a new methodology, and then they develop, and then maybe at level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4, level 5. So even though we talk about this being a target, the target must be SMART, they call it. They have this SMART tool, remember? They have to be this must be something that is specific, that is measurable, all right, so that they would be able to work it out and approach. So different people have different level of understanding, different level of progression, different level of situational conditions. So you cannot have just one goal for one person. Some can progress very, very fast, some will have to take time, and you have to be very, very, very patient. Okay, so sometimes also you have to work out with trial and error, because sometimes you may have a toolkit that you think works very well, but sometimes it doesn't work at all. Maybe it will even cause a bigger problem for your client. So this is where you got to be very sensitive to their own worries, their own fears, their own mode of depression, which can be different from A versus another person to Z. So that's why we have to be very, very cognizant of this variability, so that we do not do no harm. We do good, and we do not cause it to be more of a problem. Homework, this is very, very important, because if you want to be self-actualized, you have to be doing your own homework. So we always encourage them to do their own homework, whether it is assignment include reality testing, keeping a diary, recording their mood day by day, hour by hour, and so on. So reviewing the homework is a routine part of the session. So they bring back their homework and then you review. Alright, okay, what they have done. For example, what are the techniques in terms of the cognitive disassociation or whatever that they have, that you can teach them. And then they show how the, maybe in terms of a graph, the rate of those negative inner speech or automatic thoughts is being reduced over the period of time, so that they have a sense of success as they progress along. Feedback, alright, the therapist may constantly seek feedback through the session to check if the patients feel things are going in the right direction, because you just don't go a monologue in one way. You always go get feedback. And then maybe you have to change course, Feedback is also reducing any chance of patient not speaking out in the session. Because if you are just saying, talking, it must be a dialogue, not a monologue. Because if you must elucid, just a Socratic questioning approach, which I'll give you the idea later on how to do Socratic questioning approach. You must elucid from them their sense of self-worth, their sense of meaning, their sense of purpose, their sense of wanting to overcome their challenge in terms of depression or anxiety or whatever problems they are facing. Okay, so that's very important feedback. All right, as it can happen, make them depressed or anxious. If they're not speaking, they will get more and more anxious and more depressed. Eh? This is because self-examination is not an easy process. To go into your inner core, your inner being, and to reflect upon your inner weaknesses and difficulties is not an easy thing. So it is, you take a lot of mercy, compassion, love and care to ensure that the person is always having your highest regards, you have highest sense of confidence that you are a life coach or a teacher or a mentor that is sharing this journey together. So this is part of the work that we do. So from here we can see there are many, many evidence. I will go this into this in the next video, inshallah, and then we would be able to then understand the basic framework of PI-CBT and how we can incorporate this later on into the 5R that I'm going to revamp. Once we will publish the book, we'll give you a greater detail of our approach, inshallah.